By Master William Shakespeare, with which you are all no doubt familiar.
But what you ask are chamber players.
A question most befitting an astute and intuitive audience.
He's saying he thinks you're smart.
The chamber players are a subset of our full acting company.
We're a reduced size, a small scale cast.
Hobnob Theatre Light.
All the talent, half the calories.
Smaller in numbers, but not in size.
Well, except
Frodo Baggins over there.
We're the creative creme de la creme.
A brainy, bite-sized variation.
The baby grand of theatrical pianoforte.
The hobnob mini-me.
And now, due to our distilled cast size, we may, from time to time, require a snack, but also your assistance this evening, audience. Ooh, yes, that's yes. Don't worry, we won't embarrass you. Just you.
Nor will we ask you to act our lofty scenes in states unborn or accents yet unknown. Yes, please. Leave that to us.
We're not going to ask you to recite iambic pentameter off the cuff.
By whose like teeth in so afraid of tongue?
Show-offs.
But we may have need to draw attention to your most exquisite personage.
Or to your radiant and effusive smile. There's a dog here.
Or to your rugged and sturdy. But Tom's here.
Okay. All right. You, our esteemed audience, shall enhance our efforts, shall embolden our action, shall enliven our words.
Old men shall forget, yet all shall be forgot from this day forward until the end of the world. But with your help, our story will be remembered.
We few, we happy few, we band of brothers. And sisters.
And so, the seven of us shall take on the many and varied characters in these several different tales. Love us. Entangled in a web of confused romance.
Oh, I'm so confused about romance.
Fairies and sprites in an enchanted wood. And mythical stories of tragic devotion.
I'm so devoted to you.
I'm so devoted to you.
So much devotion. Oh, tragedy!
No, spoilers!
But we begin with Theseus.
Hi.
Who has just returned from defeating the Amazonian queen Hippolyta in battle, and thus winning her hand in marriage. Because, you know, the patriarchy?
I saw Barbie.
Yeah, so who's Hippolyta?
I'm Helena. Hermia.
Don't look at me, I'm Lysander.
Demetrius?
Oh, it's actually Demetrius.
Who's that?
Okay. If we need someone to play the enchanting and powerful queen,
No. Oh my! Here is metal more attractive. Yes, I give you Hippolyta, queen of the Amazon.
Yeah.
in its entirety.
Oh, no.
Mom said I have to be home by 8.
Right. We present selections from we present Hobnob Theater's adaptation A Midsummer Night's Dream by William Shakespeare. Yes!
Hippolyta, a nuptial hour draws apace. 4 happy days until another moon. But oh, how methinks this old moon wanes. She lingers my desires.
What he said.
Hippolyta, I wooed thee with my sword. I won thy hand doing the injury, but I would wed thee in another key. With pomp, and with triumph, and with reveling.
Oh, happy be Theseus, our renowned duke.
Cordegius, what news with thee?
Oh, full of vexation come I, and not just because of this beard. I come with complaint against my child, my daughter Hermia. Stand forth, Demetrius. Now, my noble lord, this man hath my consent to marry her. And my gracious duke, this man, Lysander, stand forth. He has bewitched the bosom of my child. Thou, Lysander, thou hast given her rhymes. He's interchanged love tokens with my child. He has, by moonlight at her window, sung. What is that? Oh, with cunning hast thou filched my daughter's heart and turned her obedience, which is due to me, into stubborn harshness. And, my gracious duke, be it so that she will not hear before your grace consent to marry with Demetrius. And I beg the ancient privilege of Athens and my beloved Texas. As she is mine, I may dispose of her, which will be either to this gentleman or to her death.
Daddy!
No, according to our law, immediately provided in that case.
What say you, Hermia? I mean, Demetrius is a worthy gentleman.
Stop.
Holy
relent, sweet Hermia, and Lysander, yield thy crazed title to my certain right.
Oh, you have her father's love, Demetrius. Let me have Hermia's. You marry him. A beauteous Hermia. Why should not I then prosecute my right? Demetrius, I'll avouch it to his head, loved Helena, till Beardy here dangled Hermia instead.
Such slander, Lysander!
Come on, bruh, he got her snap, bought her stormies, won her soul, and then ghosted her like a haunted house.
Nah, that's cap, bruh, that's cap.
Sweet lady, dotes, devoutly dotes in idolatry upon this spotted and inconstant man.
Well, I must confess I've heard so much. Demetrius, you come with me, and Aegeus, you shall come with me also, Hermia. You fit, look to yourself to fit your fancies to your father's will, or else the Athenian law gives you up to death or to a vow of single life.
Hey, fellas, I'm gonna need a jump start here. Okay.
Lysander, put her there. Good game.
Ooh!
Don't mess with the D-man, baby!
How now, my love? Why are your cheeks so pale? Oh, chance the roses there do fade so fast.
Belike for want of rain, which here could well beteem them from the tempest of my eyes.
Hear me, Hermia. I have a widow aunt. A dowager of great revenue.
Well, how much revenue?
She drives a Cybertruck.
From Athens is her house remote 7 leagues, and she respects me as her only son. There, gentle Hermia, will I marry thee? And to that place the sharp Athenian law cannot pursue us. Thou lovest me then. Steal forth thy father's house tomorrow night, and in the wood, a league without the town, where I did meet thee once with Helena, there will I stay for thee.
My good Lysander, I swear to thee, by Cupid's strongest bow, by his best arrow with the golden head, in that same place thou hast appointed me, tomorrow truly will I meet with thee.
He promised, love. Look, here comes Helena.
He loves me? Loves me not. He loves me?
He loves me not.
Yes, be fair Helena. Wither away.
Call ye me fair? Not fair again, unsay. Demetrius loves your fair. Oh, happy fair.
Teach me how you look,
and with what art you sway the motion of Demetrius' heart.
I frown upon him, yet he loves me still.
Oh, would your frowns teach my smile such skill?
The more I hate, the more he follows me.
The more I love, the more he hateth me.
Take comfort, he no more shall see my face. Lysander and myself will fly this place.
Helen, to you our minds we will unfold tomorrow night, when Phoebe doth behold her silver visage in the watery glass, decking with liquid pearl the bladed grass of time that lover's flight doth still conceal. Through Athens' gate have we devised to steal.
And in the wood, there my Lysander and myself shall meet, and thence from Athens turn away our eyes to seek new friends and stranger company.
I'll miss you too.
Farewell, sweet playfellow. Pray thou for us, and good luck grant thee thou Demetrius. Keep word, Lysander, we must starve our sight from lover's food till mar deep midnight.
I will, my Hermia. Helena, adieu. As you on him, Demetrius dote on you.
Oh, happy some or some other can be. Through Athens, I'm thought as fair as she, right? I'm very pretty. Tell me I'm pretty. But what of that? Demetrius thinks not so. He will not know all, but he do know. For ere he looked on Hermia's eye, he held down hopes that he was only mine. I will go tell him of fair Hermia's flight. Then to the wood will he tomorrow night pursue her. And for this intelligence, if I have thanks, it is at your expense, but here in me nigh to enrich my pain, to have his sight thither and back again. He loves me! Ah!
Okay. Is our company all here?
Casey's not here.
Casey, I'm changing costumes.
Well, this is awkward.
We could sing a song or something, like a musical.
Maybe we could, you know, just take like a little break, you know, like an intermission.
We literally just started.
Okay. I'm almost ready.
I know what to do. Oh. It's time for everybody's favorite game, more exposition. Okay, so in this part of the story, we got just a group of ordinary townspeople.
Howdy.
And to celebrate Theseus and Hippolyta's wedding day, they've decided to do something super normal and put on a play.
Ready?
Okay.
Finally.
Shut up. Okay. Is our company all here?
Yes.
Mary, our play is, drum roll, the most lamentable comedy and most cruel death of Pyramus and Thisbe.
A very good piece of work, I assure you.
And I wrote it.
All right, calm down, Shakespeare. And a merry ha-ha. Now, call forth the rest of the actors by the scroll.
Answer as I call you. Nick Bottom, the weaver.
Weaver, that's what you put together?
This is all we had.
Nick Bottom. You are set down for Pyramus.
What is Pyramus? A lover or a tyrant? Oh,
baby, a lover that kills himself most gallant for love.
This will ask some tears in the true performing of it. If I do it, let the audience look to their eyes. I will move storms. Oh. Now name the rest of the players.
Francis Flute, the bellows mender.
I always wanted to be a cowboy.
Okay. A flute,
You must take Thisbe on you.
And what is Thisbe? A wandering gnat? On guard!
It's the lady that Pyramus must love.
Whoa, faith, let her not play a woman. I have a beard coming.
And I may hide my face. Oh, let me play Thisbe too. I'll speak in a monstrous little voice. Thisbe! Thisbe!
Oh, Pyramus dear, and Thisbe dear, and Lady dear!
Well, you must play Pyramus and flute you Thisbe.
I'm not wearing lipstick.
Well, we'll talk about it. Robin Soglin. See, here, oil change mechanic. Okay.
Dear Prince.
Okay, you, Robin Soglin, must play Thisbe's mother.
Oh, Mom. Yes.
No line. Tom Snout, the plumber.
Oh, okay.
You must play Pyramus' father. Okay, just go over there.
Okay.
And Snug, the security guard. You, the lion's paws.
The lion.
And I hope here is a play fitted.
Aye, Mary. And if Pyramus and Thisbe bombs, we can always tour as the village people.
It's fun to stay at the
YMCA. YMCA.
What was that?
I don't know, but it was awesome.
Have you the lion's part written? Pray you, if it be given me for Obslow study.
Oh. Honey, you may do it extempore.
Extempore.
No, that's a different word.
Oh.
You may do it extempore, for it is nothing but roaring.
Oh, let me play the lion, too. I will roar. Oh, that I will do any man's heart good to hear me. I will roar. That I will make the Duke say, let him roar again. Roar! Oh, my God!
What have you done?
Okay!
Hey, you, over here. You know it. I know it. They know it. Baby, you're a star. But if we don't give the peasants a little something something, it'll be off with our heads. You feel me?
I feel you.
So, you... They play no part but Pyramus. And Masters, these are your parts. And I am to entreat you, request you, and desire you to con them by tomorrow night and meet me in the palace wood a mile without the town by moonlight. There we shall rehearse. Oh, I pray you fail me not.
Oh, bring it in, bring it in. Oh, we will meet, and there we will rehearse most obscenely and courageously. Yeah. Take pains. Be perfect. Oh. Adieu.
One,
two, three. Oh, we're bonding. That's great, guys. I'll see you there.
Hello, howdy, and bonjour. How are all you velveteen kittens out there tonight, all right? I'm Robin Goodfellow, and in case you're wondering, isn't that just another name for Shakespeare's mischievous fairy Puck? Well then, someone paid attention to English class, and you can come see me after for a gold star. All right, so tonight, we're coming at you live with some old favorites, brand new twists.
Avoiding copyright.
So, without further ado, and... Actually, with a little farther ado, when I say avoiding copyright, I mean more of like a technical, more of a hypothetical, kind of more or less.
Five, theory. Six, seven, eight.
Stars shining bright above you. Night breezes seem to whisper. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. Dream a little dreamer. Say nighty night and kiss me.
just hold me tight and tell me you miss me. When I'm alone and blue as can be, dream a little dream of moi. Thank you, Rob. Thank you so much for being here all weekend. Thank you.
How now, spirit, whither wander you? Over hill, over dale,
through bush, through briar,
over park, over pale, through flood, through fire.
I do wander everywhere, swifter than the moon's sphere,
and I serve the fairy queen, to dew her orbs upon the green.
Farewell, thou lot of spirits.
I'll be gone.
Our queen and all our elves come here anon.
King doth keep his revels here tonight. Take heed the queen come not within his sight. For Oberon is passing
fell and by broken. Moonlight, proud Titania!
Louis!
What?
It's not our...
No, that was my cue. He said Oberon.
That's what
yeah,
I...
Yeah, it's not his...
No,
not
no, I still have to explain that you and Titania are having a spat because you're jealous of her special good. Little boy thing.
What?
Okay, I heard it when I said
okay.
it.
Okay, context here. Titania, I mean, I adopted the sweetest little boy.
Well, officially, it's not on paper. It's actually my
yeah,
little
boy. That's
little
not
boy
official
there,
at all.
Actually,
that's, no, that's not
just
part of
it. Hand it over there. Come on.
Okay, we can talk
come
about
on.
It when it's the time.
I don't think there's any discussion to be had.
No,
yeah,
no,
come on.
Get off my stage.
Sorry. Thou speakest aright. I am that merry wanderer of the night. But room, fairy, here comes Oberon.
And here my mistress. Would that he were gone.
Ill met by moonlight, proud Titania.
What? Jealous Oberon? Fairies, skip hence. I have forsworn his bed and company.
Terry, rash wanton. Am I not thy lord?
Then I must be thy lady. But why art thou here? But that, forsooth, the bouncing Amazon, thy buskined mistress and warrior love, to Theseus must be wedded. And you come to give their bed joy and prosperity.
Get it,
girl. How canst thou for shame, Titania? Glance at my credit with Apollo, knowing I know thy love for Theseus. Hold on, wait. So Oberon and Theseus both have a thing for Apollo?
Yep, move it on. Okay. Oh, these are but the forgeries of jealousy. And never have we met since the middle summer spring. On hill, in dale, forest, or mead, by paved fountain, or rushy brook. But with thy brawls, thou hast disturbed our sport.
Would you amend it, then? Why should Titania cross her over on? I mean, it lies in you. I do but beg a little changeling boy.
Set your heart at rest. The fairyland buys not this child.
Let's see what you baby we want.
How long in this wood do you intend to stay?
Oh, perchance till after Theseus' wedding day. If you will, come and dance an hour round and see our moonlight revels. Go with us. If not, shun me, and I will spare your haunts. But I won't!
Give me this boy and I will go with thee.
No,
no please.
No,
I beg of you.
Not for thy fairy kingdom. Fairies, away. We shall chide downright if I longer stay.
Oh.
I'm watching you!
Go thy way! Thou shalt not from this wood till I torment thee for this injury. Oh, gentle Puck, come here. Come near there. You remember that flower I showed you once?
My lord, you've shown me many flowers.
No, remember, I am on the mountain, and I hear the mermaid singing.
No, give me a little more here.
Oh, goodness. the cupid shoots the arrow. Misses the virgin. Hits the white flower, turns it purple. Maidens call it love and idleness.
Right, that flower, yeah.
Fetch me that flower. The juice of it on sleeping eyelids laid will make man or woman madly dote upon the next live creature it sees. Fetch me this herb. Be thou here ere the leviathan can swim a league.
I'll put a girdle round about the earth in 40 minutes.
Having once this juice, I'll watch Titania while she's asleep. And drop the liquor of it in her eyes, and the next thing she waking looks upon, she shall pursue with the soul of love. And ere I take the charm off her sight, as I can take it with another herb, I will make her render up her page to me. Oh, but who comes here? I am invisible, and I shall overhear their conference.
I'm of thee, not! Therefore pursue me. Not! Where is Lysander and fair Hermia? The one I'll slay, the other slayeth me. Thou told'st me they were stolen unto this wood, and here am I, and wood within this wood. Therefore get thee gone, and follow me no more.
I am your spaniel and Demetrius. The more you beat me, I will fawn on you. Spurn me, strike me, neglect me, lose me! Only give me leave, unworthy as I am, to follow you.
Tempt not too much the hatred of my spirit, for I am sick when I do look on thee.
And I am sick when I look not on you.
Now run from me, and hide me in the brakes, and leave thee to the mercy of wild beasts.
Wildest have not such a heart as you.
I'll not stay thy questions. Let me go.
I will follow thee. To make a heaven of hell, to die upon the hand I love so well. At a slower pace, please.
Oh, fare thee well, sweet nymph. He shall not from this wood, until thou shalt fly him and he shall seek thy love. Hast thou the flower?
Aye, there it is.
Pray thee, give it me. I know a bank where the wild thyme blows, where the ox slips and the nodding violet blows, quite over canopied with what luscious woodbine and sweet musk roses and eglant. I really have shown thee a lot of flowers, haven't I? Well, there sleeps Titania some time of the night, lulled in these flowers with dances and delight. With the juice of this, I will streak her eyes and make her full of hateful fantasies. Oh, it. Take some of this. Seek throughout this grove. An Athenian lady's in love with a total jag-off. He's disdainful youth. And, anoint his eyes. And when the next thing he espies shall be...
me.
Lady. Right. Yes. You shall know him by the Athenian garments he has on. Yes. All right. And meet me here ere the first cock crow.
Fear not, my lord. Your servant shall do so.
Come now. A roundel and a fairy song. Then, for the third part of a minute hence, sing me now asleep. Then to your offices and let me rest.
Dream, 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 when I need you in my arms, when I need you, and all your charms, whenever I want you, all I have to do is dream. Dream, 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 when I feel blue, in the night when I need you, to hold me tight whenever I want you, all I have to do is dream.
Oh!
all the good fellows in every state of heaven.
What thou seest, when thou dost wake, do it for thy true love take, whether it be lynx or cat or bear or boar with bristled hair or that guy over there. Okay, that guy over there. That guy over there. Oh yes, when it comes into your eyes, yes. Oh, wake when some vile thing is near. Come on, wait, backwards, come on.
Fair love, you faint with wandering in the wood.
I do.
And to speak troth, I forgot our way. We'll rest us here, Hermia, if you think it good, and tarry for the comfort of the day.
Well, be it so, Lysander. Find you out of bed, for I upon this bank will rest my head.
One turf shall serve as pillow for us both. One heart, one bed, two bosoms, one troth.
Nay, good Lysander, for my sake, my dear, lie further off yet. Do not lie so near. It's such separation, as may well be said, becomes a virtuous bachelor and a maid.
Yeah.
So far be distant. Hey. More distant.
Hi.
Different distant. And good night, sweet friend. Thy love ne'er alter till thy sweet life end.
Here is my bed. Sleep give thee all his rest. Through the woods I have gone, but Athenian found I none. Night and silence. Oh, but who is here? Weeds of Athens he doth wear. And this the maid, sleeping sound on the dank and dirty ground. This is he, my master said, despise the Athenian maid. Churl upon thy eyes I throw, all the power this charm doth owe, so awake when I am gone, for I must now to Oberon.
Stay, though thou kill me, sweet Demetrius.
Oh, I charge thee, hands. Behind, do not.
I am out of breath, Miss Fawnchase. The more my prayer, the lesser is my grace. Who's here? Lysander on the ground? Dead? Oh. Asleep. I see no blood, no wound. Lysander! Good sir! If you live, awake! Jeez.
And run through fire I will for thy sweet sake. Transparent Helena, nature shows art that through thy bosom makes me see thy heart.
Oh, where is Demetrius? How fit a word is that vile name to perish on my sword?
Do not say so, Lysander, say not so. What, though he love your Hermia? Lord, what though? Yet Hermia still loves you. Then be content.
Content with Hermia? No, I do repent the tedious minutes I with her have spent. Not Hermia, but Helena I love, who will not change a raven for a dove.
Oh, well, wherefore was I to this keen mockery born? When at your hands did I deserve such scorn? Is not enough, young man, that I never have, no, nor never can, deserve a sweet look from Demetrius' eye? But you must flout my insufficiency. Oh, little lady, if one man refused, should another therefore be abused?
She sees not Hermia. Hermia, sleep thou there, and never mayst thou come Lysander near. And all my powers address your love and might to honor Helen and to be her knight. I'm coming for your baby.
What? Removed? Lysander? Lord? What out of hearing? Gone? No sound, no word? Alack, where are you? you, I'll find him immediately.
Are we all met?
Oh. Sarah,
I am changing costume.
Oh, well, this is awkward. Pat, here is a marvelous, convenient place for our rehearsal. This green plot shall be our stage, and this hawthorn break our siren house, and we will do it in action as we will do it before the Duke. Ow!
Quince!
What sayest thou, bully baby bubble of bottom?
I'm uncomfortable. Quince, there are things in this comedy of Pyramus and Thisbe that will never please. First, Pyramus must draw a sword to kill himself, which the ladies cannot abide. I mean, come on, don't you agree with me? Am I right? Told ya.
I believe we must leave the killing out when all is done.
Not a whit. I have a device to make all better. Write me a prologue.
A prologue?
A prologue! And let this prologue seem to say that we will do no harm with our swords, and that Pyramus is not killed indeed. And, for the more better assurance, tell them that I, Pyramus, am not Pyramus, but am Bottom the Weaver, PennDOT worker. It shall put them out of fear.
Well, we will have such a prologue.
Won't the ladies be afeared of the lion?
I fear it, I promise you.
Master, you ought to consider with yourselves to bring in, God shield us, a lion among ladies is a most dreadful thing. I mean, come on. Don't you agree? Me? Yeah? Uh-huh? Little nod? There it is. What can I say? Bottom knows the ladies.
So then there has to be another prologue that says he's not a lion?
We will have such a prologue. But, there is two hard things.
Two?
That is, to bring the moonlight into a chamber. For you know, Pyramus and Thisbe meet by moonlight.
Well, does the moonlight shine the night we play our play?
A calendar. A calendar! A cellular smart calendar!
It has
a calendar! Oh! A calendar!
A calendar!
Unlock your calendar, I beseech thee! Oh, that's not a very good password! Look in the almanac. Find out moonshine. Find out moonshine. Now that is a sturdy lawn chair. All right, focus.
Oh, yes, it doth shine that night.
Then may you leave a casement of the great chamber window where we play open, and the moon may shine in at the casement.
Oh, aye. Or else, one must come in with a bush of thorns and a lanthorn and say that he comes to disfigure or to present the person of moonshine. Huh?
Well, who's gonna do that?
Oh, Robin Stoblin, that's a role for you, baby.
Oh, I'm looking down. Portrait.
All right. Oh, yes. All right. Perfect. All right. Everyone, find your light. All right. Free advertising on three. 1, 2, 3.
Free advertising on three.
Yep. All right, we thank thee. And feel free to post that on any media socialis and tag Hobnob Theatre with an RE. It's more British that way.
But there is another thing. We must have a wall in the great chamber,
But Pyramus and Thisbe says the story did talk through the chink of a wall.
But you can never bring it in a wall. What say you, Bottom?
What say you, Bottom?
What say you, Bottom?
What say you, Bottom?
Some man or other must present wall. Let them have some plaster or loam or rough cast about them to signify wall. And let them hold their fingers thus. Thus. Through that cranny shall Pyramus and Thisbe whisper. Stand up, stand up. Do a little twirl. He's perfect!
Pyramus, you begin.
Oh, my turn. Yeah. Be patient, my protege. You can take a seat. You're okay.
All right, Pyramus. When you have spoken your speech, you enter into that break, and so everyone according to his cue.
Whoa, what happened, homespuns? Have we swaggering here so near the cradle of the fairy queen? What a play toward. I'll be an auditor. Or an actor too, perhaps, if I see cause.
Okay, speak, Pyramus. Thisbe, stand forth.
Thisbe, the flowers of odious savor sweet.
Odors, honey, odors.
Odors, savor sweet, and so hath thy breath, my dearest Thisbe. Dear. But hark, a voice? Stay thou but here a while, and by I will to thee appear.
Stranger Pyramus than air played here. Must I speak now?
Aye, marry, must you? You need to understand that he goes but to see a noise that he heard and is to come again. All right?
All right. Most radiant Pyramus.
Most radiant, most many height of you, amid the Pyramus at Ninny's tomb.
Ninus tomb.
That's what I said.
No, it's not. Okay. You must speak all your part at once, cues and all. That line that you just said, you say to Pyramus when he enters. Okay, Pyramus. You enter when your cue is passed. It is never tire. Never tire. He is ready, are you?
Oh! And truest, truest horse that yet would never tire.
If I were fair, Thisbe, I were only thine! Why do they run away? Oh, this is a knavery to make me afeard!
Listen, Bottom! Listen, how I translated!
I see their knavery. This is to make an ass of me. Write me if they could. Do what they can. I will not stir from this place. I will walk up and down here, and I will sing that they shall hear. I am not afraid. Stars shining bright above me.
What angel wakes me from my
Flowery.
pray thee, gentle mortal, sing again.
Night breezes seem to whisper.
Oh, mine ear is much enamored of thy note. So is mine eye enthralled to thy shape. Well. And thy fair virtue's force, perforce, doth move me on the first view to say, to swear, I love thee. Thou art as wise as thou art beautiful. Out of this wood, do not desire to go. Thou shalt remain here, whether thou wilt or no. And I do love thee, therefore go with me. Oh, I'll get thee fairies to attend on thee, and I'll purge thy mortal grossness so that thou shalt like an airy spirit go. Peas blossom, mustard seed, cobweb. Ready.
And I.
Come, wait upon him. Lead him to my bower.
Dream a little dream of me.
Tie up my love's tongue. Bring him silently.
Wonder if Titania be awake. And if so, what next came into her eye that she must dote on in extremity, O my messenger? How now, mad spirit, what night rule in this haunted wood?
My mistress with a monster. The monster is in love. Near to her close and consecrated bower, while she was in her dull and sleeping hour, a crew of patches, rude mechanicals, that work for bread upon Athenian stalls, were met together to rehearse a play intended for Great Theseus' nuptial day. And the shallowest thick skin of this barren sort, who Pyramus presented in their sport, forsook his scene and entered in a break when I did him at this advantage take. An ass's null I fixed on his head. An honest Thisby must be answering. And forth my mimic comes when they him spy, as wild geese away his fellows fly. And at that moment, so it came to pass, Titania waked, and straightway lo, an ass.
Oh, this comes out better than I could devise. Oh, and hast thou lashed the Athenian's eyes as I bid thee do?
I took him sleeping, that is finished too, and the Athenian woman by his side, that when she waked of force, she must be eyed.
Oh, stand aside. This is that same Athenian.
Aye, this the woman, but not this the man. Hermia, oh, why rebuke you him that loves you so? Lay breath so bitter on your bitter foe.
Now, Abbot Chad, but I should use thee worse, for thou, I fear, hast given me cause to curse. It cannot be, but thou hast murdered him. Well, so should a murderer look, so dead, so grim.
So should the murdered look, and so should I. Pierced through the heart with your stern cruelty.
Out, cur! Out, dog! Thou drivest me past the bounds of maiden's patience. Hast thou slain him, then? Henceforth, be never numbered among men.
You spend your passion on a misprized mood. I am not guilty of Lysander's blood, nor is he dead, for aught that I can tell.
I pray you tell me, then, that he is well.
And if I could, what should I get there for?
A privilege. Oh. Never to see me more. From my hated presence part, I so see me no more. Whether he be dead or no.
There is no following her in this fierce vein. Here, therefore, for a while, I shall remain. For sorrow's heaviness, doth heavier grow. For death, that bankrupt sleep doth sorrow owe.
which now, in some slight measure, it will pay, if or by his tender here, oh, I make some stay.
What hast thou done? Thou hast mistaken quite, and laid the love juice on some true love's sight. I am
Whoops.
Go thou through this wood, and Helena of Athens look you find. By some illusion, bring her here, and I'll charm his eyes against she do appear.
I go. Look how I go, swifter than the arrow from Tartar's bow.
Flower of the purple dye, hit with Cupid's archer eye, sinking apple of his eye, so when he doth his love spy, think of her as glorious lies, Venus in the sky, and when you wake, if she be by, beg of her for remedy. Remedy, oh goodness.
Captain of our fairy band, Helena is here at hand, and the youth mistook by me, now pleading for a lover's fee. Shall we there, fond pageant, see? Lord, what fools these mortals be.
The noises they make will cause Demetrius awake.
Then we'll two at once woo one. That must needs be sport alone.
Why should you think that I should woo in scorn? Scorn and derision never come.
Oh, God.
In tears, look what I vow. I weep, and vows so born, in their nativity, all truth appears.
You do advance your cunning more and more. When truth kills truth, oh, devilish holy fray, these vows are Hermia's. Will you not give her oar? Oh, wait, oath with oath, and nothing you away.
I had no judgment when to her I swore.
Nor none in my mind now you give her oar.
Demetrius loves Hermia, and he loves not you.
Oh, Helena! Goddess, nymph, perfect, divine! To what, my love, shall I compare thine eye? Oh, when thou hold'st up thy hand, oh, let me kiss this princess of pure white, this seal of bliss.
Mm. Oh, spite! Oh, hell! I see you all are bent to join against me for your merriment. Can you not hate me, as I know you do? But you must join in souls to mock me too. If you were men, as men you are, you'd show, you would not use a gentle lady so.
You are unkind, Demetrius. Be not so, for you love Hermia. This you know I know.
Lysander, keep thy Hermia. I will not. If e'er I loved her, all that love is gone.
Helen, I in faith, it is not so.
Disparage not the faith thou dost not know. Look where thy love comes. Yonder is thy dear.
Thou art not the man I, Lysander, found mine ear at thank you, brought me to thy sound. But why unkindly didst thou leave me so?
Why would he stay? Whom love doth press to go?
What love could press Lysander from my side?
Lysander's love that would not let him bide. Fair Helena, who more in kills the night than all your fiery oohs and eyes of light, why would thou seek me? Could not this let thee know the hate I bear thee made me leave thee so?
You speak not as you think. It cannot be. Oh, she is one of this confederacy. Now I perceive they have conjoined all three to fashion this false sport in spite of me. Injurious Hermia, most ungrateful maid, have you conspired with these? Have you contrived to bait me with this foul derision?
I am amazed at your passionate words. I scorn you not. It seems that you scorn me.
Did you not set Lysander as in scorn to follow me and praise my eyes and face? And made your other love, Demetrius, who even but now could spurn me with his foot, to call me goddess, name divine and rare, precious.
Bless you. I understand not what you mean by this.
I do persever, counterfeit sad looks, make vows upon me when I turn my back, wink each at other, keep the sweet jest up. But fare you well. 'Tis partly my own fault, which death or absence soon shall remedy.
Stay, gentle Helena! My love, my life, my soul, fair Helena!
Oh, excellent! Sweet, do not scorn her so!
Helen, I do love thee. By my life, I do. I swear by that which I will lose for thee.
to prove him false that says I love thee not.
And I say I love thee more than he can do.
If thou say so, withdraw and prove it too.
Quick, come!
And I say in your hands all this.
Hang off, thou cat, thou burr, vile thing. Let loose, or I will shake thee from me like a serpent.
Why are you grown so rude? What changes this sweet love?
Thy love? Out, tawny tartar, out! Hated potion, loathed medicine, hence!
Do you not jest? Yes, soothe him, so do you!
Demetrius, I will keep my word with thee.
I would I had your bond, for I perceive a weak bond holds you. I'll not trust your word.
What? Should I hurt her? Strike her, kill her dead? Although I hate her, I'll not harm her so.
What? Can you do me greater harm than hate? Hate me? Wherefore? Oh, me. What news, my love? Am I not Hermia? Are you not Lysander? I'm as fair now as I was ere while since night you loved me. Here since night you left me. Why then you left me?
Aye, by my life, and never did desire to see thee more. Therefore, be out of hope, of question, of doubt. Be certain, nothing truer. 'Tis no jest that I do hate thee. And love Helena.
You, juggler, you thief of love, you kicked your boss out!
What? You can't say that.
Yeah, I went there. I was born there. What? Have you come by night and stolen my love's heart from him?
What? Will you tear impatient answers from my gentle tongue? Fie, fie, you counterfeit, you puppet, you! That's right, I also went there.
That way goes the game now. I perceive she hath made compare between our statures. She hath erred her hat, and with her personage, her tall personage, her hat, forsooth, she hath prevailed with him. And are you grown so high in his esteem because I am so dwarfish and so low? How low am I, thou painted maypole? Speak, how low am I? I am not yet so low, but that my nails can reach unto thy hands.
Will you walk me, gentlemen? Let her not hurt me. You perhaps may think, because she is something lower than myself, that I can match her.
Lower! Hark again.
Be not afraid, Helena. She shall not harm thee.
No, sir, she shall not, though you take her part.
Oh, when she is angry, she is keen and shrewd. She was a vixen when she went to school. And though she be but little, she is fierce.
Little! I can't. Nothing but low and little. Why would you suffer her to flout me thus? Let me come now!
Get you gone, you dwarf! You minimus of hindering not grass maid! You bee! You acorn!
You are too officious in her behalf that scorns your services. Let her alone. Speak not of Helena. Take not her part.
Now, she holds me not. Now follow, if thou darest, to try who's right, of thine or mine, is most in Helena's.
Dost thou want a piece of me?
Oh, don't be singing it if you're not bringing it. Oh.
Fight. Ow, I got you. No, I got you. No, I dodged it, bro. No points. None.
You, mistress, all this coil is long of you.
I will not trust you, nor longer stay in your cursed company. Your hands and mine are quicker for a fray. My legs are longer, though. Run away!
I am amazed and know not what to say.
This is thy negligence! Still thou makest, or else committest thy knaveries willfully.
Believe me, King of Shadows, I mistook. Did you not tell me I should know the man by the Athenian garments he had on?
Thou seest, these lovers seek a place to fight. Oh, hie therefore, Robin, and hie
Lime.
Hey, Lewis. You can't call Lime because it's not rehearsal. Make it work, bud.
I mean, crap. Ah, die. Die, therefore, Robin. Use thy magical spells and make Demetrius and Lysander run around like gazelles till they're tired and very sleepy and do the same with the girls, but don't be creepy. take this and remove the spell from Lysander. Oh, goodness, Lysander. So that when he sees Hermia, he can stand her. Oh, yeah, and I'll go to Titania and remove the spell. And when she wakes, all will be well. Oh, yeah, suck it, Shakespeare.
For my next trick. I have here a deck of cards. You, sir, yes, you right there. To save time, I've gone ahead and picked your card for you. We have Titania, Queen of the Fairies. Right, all right. Shuffling round and round she goes. Where she stops, nobody knows. All right, go ahead and take that card right off the top. Show everybody. Is that your card?
No.
What's this in my pocket? What? How did you? Wow, this guy. Love this guy. Ladies and gentlemen. No, how you did it. Thank you. Thank you.
Sit thee down upon this flowery bed while I thy amiable cheeks do coy and stick musk roses in thy sleek, smooth head and kiss thy fair, large ears, my gentle joy.
Where's Peas Blossom?
Oh, almost here, my sweet. Just one more moment. Ready!
Scratch my head, Peas Blossom. Where's Monsieur Cobweb?
Ready.
Monsieur Cobweb, good, Monsieur. Get you your weapons in hand and kill me a red-hipped humblebee on the top of a thistle. And, good Monsieur, bring me the honey bag.
The honey bag, okay.
Where's Monsieur Mustard Seed?
What's your will?
Nothing, good Monsieur, but to help Cavalry Cobweb to scratch up. Oh, I must to the barber, good Monsieurs, for methinks I am marvelous hairy about the face, and oh, I am such a tender ass, if my hair do but tickle me, oh, I must scratch. Oh, here comes the cavalry. Here we go.
Music! Will you hear music, my love? Or say, sweet love, what thou desirest to eat?
Methinks I have a great desire to a bottle of hay. Good hay, sweet hay. Have no fellow.
Oh, I have a venturous fairy that shall seek out the squirrel's hoard and fetch thee new nuts.
My nuts work just fine, thank you. I would rather have a handful or two of dried peas, but I pray you, let none of your people stir me, for I feel an exposition of sleep come upon me.
Sleep thou, and I will wind thee in my arms. Fairies, be gone, and be always away. So doth the woodbine, the sweet honeysuckle, gently entwist. Oh, how I love thee, how I dote on thee.
Welcome, Robin. Seest thou this sweet sight? Oh, her dotage now I do begin to pity. She's a hot mess. gentle Puck, remove the transformed scalp from the Athenian swain, but first I shall awake the fairy queen. Seest thou what want to see? Beest thou what want to be? And now, awake, my
queen. My Oberon! Oh, what visions have I seen? Methought I was enamored of an axe!
And there lies thy love. Silence! Silence! Robin, take off his head.
Whoa! Take off my head!
No! Just the donkey bit on top.
Oh, right. Sorry. Hey, do you guys think I could borrow this after the show? There was this furry
convention. No! Musical!
Musical! Music, such as charming sleep. Come, my lord, and in our flight, tell me how it came this night that I, sleeping here, was found with these mortals on the ground.
You're not going to like it.
Now, when thou wakest with thine own fool's eyes, peep. We're taking this away.
Oh, friends, Romans, country. Oh!
When my cue comes, call me, and I will answer. My next is Most Fair Pyramus. Hey ho! Quince? Flute? Snout? Starveling, here, boy! Cuts my life! Stolen hence and left me here asleep! I have had a most rare vision. I had a dream past the wit of man to say what a dream it was. A man is but an ass if he will go about to expound this dream. Methought I was, there is no man can tell what. Methought I was, and methought I had, but man is but a patched fool if he will offer to say what methought I had. I will get Quince to write a ballad of this dream, and it shall be called Bottom's Dream, because it hath no bottom, and I will sing it in the latter end of the play. Before the Duke! Oh, yeah, baby! A poor thumbadier, how you like the hunt? Hounds, horses, and horns. Oh, we sail, my dear queen, up to the mountain, and mark the musical confusion of hounds. That means you.
an echo in conjunction. Oh, 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 oh.
My lord, this is my daughter here asleep. And this is Lysander. And that's Helena. And this is Demetrius. No wonder they're being here together.
Stand up. Stand up, I say.
No, I've been here the whole time.
Oh, I know you two are rival enemies. How comes this gentle concord in the world?
My lord, I shall reply amazedly, half sleep, half waking, but as yet, I swear, I came with Hermia hither. Our intent was to be gone from Athens where we might, without the peril of the Athenian law.
Oh, enough, enough, my lord. You have enough? I beg the law upon his head. They would have stolen away. They would, Demetrius, thereby to have defeated you and me. You of your wife and me of my consent. Of my consent that she should be your wife.
Okay, Boomer.
I don't know what it means, but it doesn't sound very nice.
My good lord, Fair Helen told me of their stealth, and I, in fury, hither following them. Fair Helena, in fancy, following me. But, my good lord, I wot not by what power, but by some power it is. My love for Hermia melted as the snow.
Oh, thank God.
And all the faith, the virtue of my heart, the object and pleasure of mine eye, is only Helena.
I'll take it.
Oh, fair love, as you fortunately met. Egregious, I shall overbear your will, for in the temple, by and by with us, these lovers shall eternally be met. And as for the morning, it's now something worn up purpose, something shall be set aside. Away with us to Athens, 3 and 3, we'll hold a feast in great solemnity.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the stage, Puck.
Sweet dreams till sunbeams find you. Sweet dreams that leave all worries behind you. Sweet dreams, whatever they be. Dream a little dream of me.
Thank you.
To Bottom's house. Has he come home yet?
He cannot be heard of. I doubt he is transported.
Or if he comes not, then the plan is barred. It goes not forward, doth
it? Oh, it is not possible. Oh, you have not a man in all of Athens able to discharge Pyramus, but he...
No, he hath simply the best wit of any handicraft man in Athens.
Masters, the Duke is coming from the temple, and there's 2 or 3 lords and ladies more married. If our sporting got poured, we'd all be made men.
Oh, shucks.
Where are these lads? Where are these hearts?
Oh, Bottom! Oh. Most courageous day, most happy hour!
Masters, I am to discourse wonders, but ask me not what. For if I tell you I am no true Athenian, oh, I'll tell you everything right as it fell out.
Let us hear, sweet Bottom.
Not a word from me. All that I will tell you is that the Duke hath dined.
Oh. Who cares? Whatever you're talking about.
I'll get you your apparel together and meet presently at the palace. Every man look o'er his part, for the short and long is our play is preferred. In any case, let Thisbe have clean linen, and let not him that plays the lion pare down his nails, for they shall hang out
as the lion's claws.
I'm a little bit nervous.
Never too late to recast.
Hey.
And, dear actors, eat no onions nor garlic, for we are to utter sweet breath. I'm looking at you, Grant. And I do expect to hear them say, it is a sweet comedy. No more words. Away. Go away.
Oh, joy, gentle friends, and fresh days of love. Oh, Polita, what masks, what dances shall we have to wear away the long age of 3 hours between after supper and a bedtime? Oh, is there no revels at hand? Is there no play to ease the anguish of a torturing hour? Oh, look, you have a bill of plays. Kindly read it for us. What mask, what music, how shall we beguile the lazy time if not with some delight? I pray you stand and pronounce. There we are.
A tedious, brief scene of young Primus and his love, this be. Very tragical mirth.
Very tragical. Tedious and brief. That is hot ice and very strange snow. Shall we hear the play?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, Apollo, the prologue has announced, I prithee excuse me while I visit the privy.
Gentles, perchance you wonder at this show, but wonder on till truth makes all things plain. This man is Pyramus. If you will know. This beauteous lady. Woo! Thisbe is certain. This man, with lime and rough cast, doth present wall. Always doing great. This wall, which did these lovers sunder, and through wall's chink, poor souls, they are content to whisper. Okay, at the witch, let no man wonder. This man, with lanthorn, dog, and bush of thorn, presenteth moonshine. This is going so good. Which, if you will know, by moonshine did these lovers think no scorn to meet at Ninus' tomb, there to woo. This grisly beast, which lion hight by name, the trusty Thisbe, coming first by night, did scare away, or rather did affright. And as she fled, her mantle she did fall, which lion, vile with bloody mouth, did stain. Anon comes Pyramus, sweet youth, and tall.
6'4", thank you.
And finds his trusty Thisbe's mantle slain. Whereat, with bloody, blameful blade, he bravely broached his boiling, bloody breast. And Thisbe, tarrying in mulberry shade, his dagger drew and died. For all the rest, let lion, moonshine, wall, and lovers twain at large discourse while they here do remain. That means they're going to do the play now.
Wait, that wasn't the play?
Regulate!
Okay, so
In this interlude, it doth befall that I snout by name, and oh wait, what's your name?
Wall.
That's a coincidence. Okay, I'm snout present Wall, and such a wall as we would have you think it had a crannied hole or chink.
Chink.
There we go. Yeah, and through which the lovers, Thermus and Bisbee, did whisper often secretly. This loam, this rough cast in stone, doth show that I, we, us, are that same wall. The truth be so. And this chink, right and sinister. Oh, wow. And through which the fearful lovers did often whisper.
Oh, grim-looking night. Oh, night with hue so black. Oh, night, whichever art when day is not. Oh, night, alack, alack, alack. I fear my Thisbe's promise is forgot. And thou, oh wall, oh sweet, oh lovely wall, that stands between her father's ground and mine. Thou wall, oh sweet, oh lovely wall, show me thy chink to blink through with mine eye. Thanks, courteous wall. Jove shield thee well for this. But what see I? No Thisbe do I see. Oh, wicked wall, through whom I see no bliss. Cursed be thy stones for thus deceiving me.
My moan.
Parted my fair Pyramus. My cherry lips have often kissed. Thy stones with...
I see a voice. Now I to the chink to spy, and I hear my Thisbe's face. Thisbe,
my love, thou art my love. I think.
Think what thou wilt. I am thy lover's grace. Oh, kiss me through the hole of this vile wall. No onions or garlic. I said it, Grant.
I'm sorry.
You ate both.
I have a problem.
How did you have the time?
I just start with one and I can't stop.
Just do your next line.
I kissed the wall's hole, not your lips at all.
Wilt thou at Ninny's tomb meet me straight away?
Tide life, tide death, I come without delay.
Thus, our part wall discharged, so wall away doth go.
You did good. That's great. Oh, great. Oh,
you ladies, you whose gentle hearts do fear the smallest monstrous mouse that creeps on floor, made out for chips, both quick and tremble here when lion rough in wildest rage doth roar.
Oh, here is old Ninny's tomb, but where is my love?
Roar!
Thank you.
Moon, I thank thee for thy sunny beams. I thank thee, moon, for shining now so bright. For by thy gracious golden glittering gleams, I trust to take of truest Thisbe sight. But stay, O spite! But mark, poor knight, what dreadful dole is here! Eyes, do you see? How can it be? Oh, dainty duck, oh dear!
thy mantle good? What? Stained with blood! Approach, ye Furies fell! Oh, Fates, come! Come, cut thread and thrum! Quail, crush, conclude, and quail! Come, tears, confound! Come on, cry, cry, cry! Dang it! Out, sword, and wound that pap of Pyramus. Aye, that left pap where heart doth hop. Thus die I, thy! That's the one! Now am I dead? Now am I fled? My soul is in the sky. Tongue, lose thy light. Moon, take thy flight. Moon, take thy flight! Oh. Now, die, die. Die!
Oh, asleep, my love. What? Dead? My dove? Oh, Pyramus, arise! Speak, speak. Quite dumb. Dead! Dead!
Can I touch your face?
Oh my god!
A dew must cover thy sweet eyes! These cherry lips, this cherry nose, these yellow cowslip cheeks are gone! My god! Lovers, make moan! His eyes were green as leeks! Oh, come, sisters three! Come, come to me with hands as pale as milk. Lay that man gore, since you have shore with shears his thread of silk. Tongue, not a word. Come, trusty sword. Come, blade, my breast in row. Oh! Farewell, friends. Thus is the end. A two.
Daz.
Midnight has told 12. Your fair lovers sought to bed, and this palpable gross play has well beguiled the heavy gate of night. Oh, yes, my fair friends to bed. Oh, a fortnight hold we this solemnity. Oh, the nightly revels, a new jollity, and I guess that's it.
Wait. No. I still have some lines in here.
Yeah.
What?
Really? Yeah, the epilogue.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh, please proceed. Go right ahead.
If we shadows have offended, then think but this, and all is mended. That you have but slumbered here while these visions did appear. And this weak and idle theme no more yielding but a dream. Gentles, do not reprehend. If you pardon, we will mend. And as I am an honest puck, if we have unearned luck now to scape the serpent's tongue, we will make amends ere long, or else the puck a liar call.
Wait, no. Is this really a happy ending? I mean, the only reason why Demetrius is in love with
with Helena's because of your little spell.
Right. I mean, whatever. The way it's written is good. Yeah, and Beardy over there was ready to have me killed an hour ago. Now we're all like, it's all good. Everything's fine.
Yeah, Titania, you know, you said some hurtful things to me earlier, and I'm not sure I'm over them yet,
okay,
you know?
Okay, but that's how it's written, people.
But it's our adaptation, right?
Yeah, we can do what we want here.
Yeah, but we're not going to change the ending. Well, come on, you guys. These people came to see A Midsummer Night's Dream, right?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Okay. And so that's what we're going to give them.
Yeah.
Demetrius and Helena are in love. And Lysander and Hermia are in love.
Sorry,
and Theseus, come here. I know that you and Hippolyta are in love.
Hi.
And Oberon and Titania are still in love. And Pyramus and Thisbe are dead. But they were in love.
That one was real.
Too real. Not here. No.
So if anybody from the Peanut Gallery has anything else to say, you better take it up with Shakespeare.
Okay. Can I finish now?
Bring us home.
So good night unto you all. Give me your hands if we be friends, and Robin shall restore amends.
You like that, huh? Yeah, I know.